Hi guys, welcome back to Absolute Brushes. If you're new here, I'm Pranjali. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today I'm taking inspiration from Christmas to create this very soft and easy to do makeup tutorial. So if you want to know how I got this look, please keep on watching. I'm starting out with first spraying my face with this setting spray by PAC. For primer, I like to begin with this hydrating primer by Makeup Forever on my dry patches, followed by Milani Prime Perfection for the rest of my face. Next, I fill in the pores of my forehead and my nosy with the Baby Skin Insta Pore Eraser Primer, and for the pores under my eyes, I like to use the Benefit Professional Primer. To even out the pigmentation around my mouth, I'll first neutralize its undertones with my Salmon Color Corrector by Miss Claire. If you have a deeper skin tone than mine, please feel free to go with an orange color corrector. The deeper your skin tone or the deeper your pigmentation is, the deeper will be your color corrector. For foundation, I'm going to be using the PAC HD Liquid Foundation in the shade 3.9, and to blend it, I'm using a Damn Beauty Blender. As you can tell with this foundation, your skin looks naturally luminous. It gives you a light to medium buildable coverage, which I personally love. For concealer, I'm using the PAC Take Cover Concealer in the shades Dark Nude and Beach Sand. I'm going to use this mostly to highlight my under eye area, forehead, chin and nosy, and to blend it, I'm using an angled flat top kabuki brush from Cuffs & Lashes. To give some dimension and structure to my face, I'll be contouring my face with the Wet n Wild Duo Stick in the shade Medium. This is darker than my skin tone, so it will help in creating those shadows that got concealed with the foundation. I'm using this in the usual places like my cheekbones, circumference of my face, my jawline and my nosy, and to blend it, I'm using my angled flat top kabuki brush from Cuffs & Lashes. To bring back that warmth to my face, I'll be using a bronzer. This one's Hoola Bronzer by Benefit Cosmetics, and this will go right above my contour. And to apply it, I'm using my angled brush. For blush, I'm picking up this rosy pink shade from the Ofra Cosmetics Signature Palette and I'm using an angle brush to apply it. For highlighter, I'm using the shade Moonstone from the Sun Dipped Glow Kit Palette by ABH Cosmetics on the highest points of my face and I'm using my fan brush to apply it. And to set and seal everything in place, I'll be using a setting spray. This one's by PAC. To clean up underneath my eyebrows, I'm using the PAC Take Cover Concealer in the shade Beach Sand and I'm setting it with my loose powder. This one's by Maybelline. For my brows, I'm just filling in the sparse areas with this brown eyeshadow from Makeup Revolution Ultra Eyeshadow Palette. And I am using a spoolie to spread the color across so that it looks more natural. And to get those dramatic straight edges, I'll be using a sticky tape. To soften my crease area, I'm dipping into this nude brown shade from Smoky Obsessions palette by Huda Beauty with my larger blending brush by Real Techniques. I'm using the same nude brown shade from the Smoky Obsessions palette to deepen my crease line further with my PAC brush in the style 126 and I'm blending it using my smaller blending brush by ABH Cosmetics. To deepen my outer corner, I am dipping into this deep emerald shade from Nautical Nonsense palette by Wet n Wild with my smaller pencil brush by Real Techniques and I am blending it using my smaller blending brush by ABH Cosmetics. To further darken my outer corner, I'm picking up this deep charcoal shade from Sephora Color Festival Blockbuster palette with my angled brush. And if you notice closely, I am not taking this shade as higher as the emerald shade because I want that nice ombre effect to my outer corner. And I'm using my PAC brush in the style 126 to blend it into the other eyeshadows. I'm using the same nude brown eyeshadow from the Smoky Obsessions palette to smoke out my lower lash line with my PAC brush in the style 126. And to brighten my inner corners, I'm using the shade Vermeer from Modern Renaissance palette by ABH Cosmetics with my smaller pencil brush by Real Techniques. And to line my top lash line, I'm using the Lakme Insta Liner. to finish up my eye makeup, I'll be throwing on some falsies, but before that I'll be curling my lashes and I'll be coating them with some mascara. This one's Total Temptation by Maybelline. And for my lipstick, I'm using this deep brick shade in Vogue by Faces Canada. And for falsies, I'm using the Ardell Natural Lashes in the style 104. And here is the finished look. I've paired it up with a Santa cap and a green top to stay true to the vibe of Christmas. Quite honestly, this is the look I pictured myself in while attending those Christmas celebrations. Simple and elegant. Let me know what look would you guys had gone for. Soft and timeless or bold and beautiful. And if you liked this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you're new here, please take a moment to subscribe. I post several videos a week. I've left the link to my social media accounts in the description box down below in case you want to follow me there. I love you guys so much. Merry Christmas to all of you, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.